two of them are tied up. And the ankle, that twisted is even the ankle that was nearest to Charm. So it's one of those things where your skate kind of picks. And then your ankle decides it's going to roll because the foot's not going to. And it was just one of those things that there's no way Chara could have planned that. So, to me, that's not a slip foot. To me, a slip foot is your skater and you have no idea there, and I just come up and put my foot out behind you, and, you know, your ass over to kill. So that to me, has been a slip foot. I've watched Marshawn's done it plenty of times where we did it to Cromwell a few years ago, and I rightly thought he should have been suspended, and nothing happened. So I have no problem calling out Boston when they do it. I just didn't see that being slip foot.
Do you think Ulevi comes in to replace Myers if needed?
I have a feeling to go with Ben. I have a funny feeling it'll be Jamie Benn. Or Jory Benn, not Jamie Benn. Jamie Benn's not a conductor call entirely. That's a scary thought.
Sign of old age.
I actually picked up Jamie Benn. Well, it's easy to mix up Jamie and Jory Benn because they're so close to one another.
In
names. No! Jamie and Jory are very close. They both start with J and they both end with Y. That's why I'm picking up the card. I'm going to name this thing.
Even if I was eliminating my caps, I'll root for them because I'm a big Trunks fan. Never should have let him do it.
Yeah, when he wanted a little more money after winning that Stanley Cup, they should have been. I was really surprised they didn't. He was the first coach that figured out how to get them to a cup in over 4 years. And I was really surprised they didn't keep him around because, honestly, I think that's hurt them since then.
I think a lot of us Caps fans wanted Trump fired until about May of 2018.
So the football will be at the 25.
That's what Greg Roberts called Julian Edelman. It cost him during the run to the Stanley Cup that River Instead wanted to be fired because he wasn't playing Sagan. They don't think Sagan should be in the lineup. I was one of the ones that thought he wasn't playing Sagan.
America. Disagree.
No.
I'm totally okay with
Nazis.
set to take the field here as they have the football in the final minute of this first quarter. On first and 10, Lawrence. Oh, that was dangerous. He threw it into coverage, almost picked. But instead, they'll keep it on second down. After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Now Joe Mixon. And he'll get only a couple up to the 22.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, and you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback on the expected passing situation.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. 17 yards and a giant first down. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. Mixon with a first down carry. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. No score after one on EA Sports. Here's a second and 7. He gets this in the hands of Mixon. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. It's a game of 11 and a giant first down.
And they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because even on the last drive, they went 3 and out.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Mixon. He's brought down at the 34. Call it a game of 4.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
This is Lewis.
Here's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. They'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
They'll try to run for Lewis. And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24. Give him the third down conversion. 5 yards on the play.
But they're getting ready to go to work now and climb real estate after that last run. Found his spot. Picked up nice yardage, didn't he?
Yeah, he's got him knocking on the door of the red zone. He's able to work free for about 6 down to the 18.
Fuck!
Now after the running play, we got Joe, the field. We'll get an update when we return to MetLife Stadium.
Oh, boy.
The last run got 6 down 2nd and 4. 2nd and 4. Another good completion on the drive as the Giants have a first down.
A lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Everything's more condensed. It has to be
quicker
to deliver the ball on time. Your biggest win, ball gets tipped in the air. Because if that happens, then it's fair game for the defense.
It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down. One more time and wins it. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about 3. They'll look to make it 3 for 3 on third down conversions. They need a yard here. And that one going nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. Defense didn't budge on third down. Now what are we going to see on fourth?
We'll soon to find out. But does this feel like old school football? This is old-fashioned goal line stand.
I know what I would think all around two, but if they're in a really strong battle and they
so the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. All that remains is to snap this once, and that'll do it for the first half of play. So we've reached halftime at a low score. And now due to apparent time constraints, we fast forward to the beginning of the second half.
36 Celsius.
Second half ready to roll. 2 field goals to combine output in half number 1. Would be first touchdown wins. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line.
Stupid hot. That's the temperature it is. Stupid hot.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. On first down, Lawrence. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Defensive end, DeMarcus Lawrence applied the heat. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of football before he knew it. He was on the back.
That just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. Great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
They only get a yard back there. They'll be left with a third down and long. Throwing on third and long, Lawrence, and he gets the running back, Deion Lewis. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A gain of 19 on third and 18, and that'll move the chains.
Good route, good pickup for first down yardage. And that is a tough one to cover, the angle route, because a running back getting out of the backfield, if you're trying to cover that, especially if you're in the linebacker spot, and you're seeing this play develop, he heads out towards the flat first, and that often gets you to overcommit running in that direction. Then he cuts back up inside you into the middle of the field. That's what we just saw there for a nice pickup.
Second and three. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. DeMarcus Lawrence picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
Yeah, the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and you see yet another.
Even if they don't make it out of this one.
Now the offense back out onto the field as they'll take over here in the final minute of this third quarter. Off the play fake. Lawrence.
Dude! Boy!
DeMarcus Lawrence able to record his fifth sack of the season.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Oh, no choice.
Intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Blair. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
It reminds me of the Black Ice jerseys. So it's kind of automatic and I'm not going to
use it. Incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Throwing again, Lawrence. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. And you hate to say it, for the rookie quarterback, he's done some good things, but overall, he's a little bit overwhelmed back there, hasn't he?
He certainly has, but he hasn't had a lot of time to throw the football.
Oh, the pressure too great, and it goes down once more. DeMarcus Lawrence in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year. And they're indeed going to go.
Okay, guys, we need.
So trailing in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Looking deep for Hilton.
And what?
Incomplete. Boy, look at him. He had it and dropped it.
Oh my gosh.
So the
okay, so stupid! Block!
Throwing on first down, Lawrence. And he will go down. The Cowboys sack. DeMarcus Lawrence. He's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
Okay, let's run.
At least get some of those yards back.
10 yards.
Second and 19. A draw play here for Lawrence.
Thank God. Thank God.
Nice job there on the escape and scramble. A first down, a 16-yard game. And they're trying to squeeze your right. He's going to take off with it. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. So it's Giants football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Looking to throw. Morris. And he's got his receiver. That's Sammy Watkins. 17 yards and a Giant first down. Clock management definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agree. They have to up the tempo in this case. Down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
He's got a little here. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. A really nice gain of 25 yards. Back to throw. Morris. And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything.
God damn it. We lost.
Fourth quarter as this offense gets ready to take over. On first down, Morris. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. And Xavier Woods with a pick, and he'll bring this one back to the 29. So this one will end in a victory for the Dallas Cowboys. And I know I'm not breaking any news when I say that any